Booster V3 and Starship V3 mark the beginning of a highly anticipated new phase, and recent information suggests its arrival could be as soon as the end of this year. But can it really happen? After examining recent developments, it appears SpaceX is not building the necessary equipment as quickly as previously anticipated. This raises doubts about the potential for the maiden flight to take place this year. So, what is the current state of affairs? Why might the first V3 launch be delayed? And what steps does SpaceX need to take to stay on schedule? Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. It is widely known that after Flight 11, Starship will officially enter its new phase, V3. Musk and other reliable sources have clarified that this transition is expected to begin later this year with the launch of Flight 12, which combines B-18 and S-39. Based on the planned schedule, December seems to be the projected month for the launch. However, despite December being in the spotlight, significant uncertainty remains about whether all crucial systems will be ready in time. While nothing can be ruled out, achieving these goals depends on SpaceX significantly increasing its efforts across all areas. Currently, progress appears to be lagging behind expectations, leaving the possibility of delaying the V3's first flight until next year. Let's start with the spacecraft itself. As of now, S-39 has not yet launched. Some of its components, such as the nose cone, have been observed at Starractory for months, but there hasn't been much visible progress. It appears SpaceX is waiting for all components to be completed so they can be assembled and stacked continuously. While this method is efficient, it inevitably wastes valuable time. We're already in October. Even if SpaceX were to begin stacking S-39 immediately, the entire stacking and integration process is expected to take about a month. This is not a standard assembly process. S-39 is the first prototype of V3. As with any completely new version, the assembly process is likely to take longer than usual. Considering that S-33, the first prototype of the V2 era, took about 30 days to complete the entire stack. Based on that comparison, S-39 will likely require the same time frame or even longer. This suggests that the S-39 may not be fully assembled until November. What happens after that? The vehicle is required to complete a comprehensive series of cryogenic endurance tests and static fire tests. Between each phase, there are further inspections, transfers, and installations. This could add another month to the timeframe. If all goes well, the S-39's testing campaign could accelerate to December, but this is contingent on very smooth progress. If delays occur, which are common with early prototypes, the timeframe could be even longer. Once the S-39 completes its testing campaign, there will still be final checks, payload integration, and system installations to complete before heading to the launch pad. This process alone could take about a week. If everything proceeds as planned, S-39 may be positioned for a launch attempt in late December. However, the margin for this timeline is very narrow, and any setbacks could delay its inaugural flight until 2026. Another critical aspect to consider is the testing system itself. The previous assessments hinge on the readiness of the testing framework for ship version 3. But is that the case? Following the S-36 event, the testing setup for the ships sustained significant damage. To accommodate a new version, SpaceX might be required to construct a completely new test platform. Thus far, advancements have only been apparent in the booster testing area, not regarding the ships. B-18, which is the first V3 booster, hasn't even initiated any visible testing. This raises an essential question: when will the ship testing system be ready? Additionally, when will Ship 39 truly kick off its testing phase? At this point, making predictions is challenging. Next, we should examine the launch infrastructure. As Starship makes the transition to V3, it is anticipated that Pad 2 at Starbase will become the primary launch location. However, construction and installation at that site remain ongoing. Observations have indicated that smaller components are still being added. Some assessments have already occurred, including movements of the chopsticks and water deluge tests conducted at the flame trench, but these actions are merely preliminary. The key milestone will be a comprehensive test involving a prototype. The launch pad must withstand the incredible forces and vibrations produced when Raptor 3 engines ignite at maximum thrust. This entails that SpaceX will have to conduct testing campaigns utilizing either a dedicated tank or an official booster. To date, there has been no evidence of such preparations. At the earliest, this test might be scheduled for late October or November. It will only be after those events that the booster can proceed to an official static fire. This implies that regardless of how swiftly B-18 is constructed, the readiness of the pad could impede its journey to flight. Another obstacle for Starship V3 pertains to the engines, specifically the Raptor 3. The initial prototype of Raptor 3, referred to as SN1, was unveiled in August of the previous year. Over a year has elapsed, and theoretically, SpaceX should have manufactured numerous engines by this point, particularly given the rapid development observed with Raptor 2. Yet the reality is different. Based on sightings at Star Factory and updates from trustworthy sources, the highest numbered engine reported so far is merely SN35. As for the vacuum version, the highest count noted is SN8, which Musk showcased earlier this year. This is alarming, since each Starship mission demands at least 39 engines, 33 for Super Heavy and 6 for the ship, 3 of which need to be optimized for vacuum conditions. While there is a possibility that SpaceX may possess additional engines not visible to observers, the current indicators imply that production has not reached the required levels for V3. Conversely, the small number of Raptors observed suggests the initiative may still be in its infancy. Until more engines are available, Raptor 3 continues to be one of the key challenges preventing the first V3 launch this year. If SpaceX is unable to launch in December, there will be broader implications. Any delay in testing will delay future flights. Key objectives, such as consistently achieving orbit, capturing spacecraft, and demonstrating in-orbit refueling, will be further pushed back. This, in turn, reduces the time available to prepare for ambitious missions, including NASA's Artemis program, which relies on Starship to transport astronauts to the moon, and the long-term goal of launching the first uncrewed mission to Mars. Delays also mean less time to address emerging issues. SpaceX relies on rapid testing and development, but if each phase is delayed by several months, the learning rate will decrease dramatically. This is why ensuring the first V3 flight occurs as early as possible is crucial. Even if the 12th flight takes place in late December, it will lay the groundwork for faster progress toward 2026. There are other practical issues at stake. If no V3 flight takes place this year, 2.5 months after the 11th flight will pass without a launch, wasting a valuable opportunity. For a program as ambitious as Starship, every available month is crucial. So, will Flight 12 actually take off this year? On paper, it makes sense. However, several significant challenges remain, including the fact that S-39 hasn't been stacked, the ship's test system isn't complete, Pad 2 is still under development, and Raptor 3 production hasn't met expectations. For all of these reasons, the chances of seeing a Starship V3 launch before the end of December are slim, though not impossible. What's your perspective? Do you believe the first V3 flight can take off in 2025, or will it need to wait until next year? Share your thoughts in the comments below. The goal here isn't to criticize SpaceX, but rather to assess the situation and consider what lies ahead. Speaking of developments, the countdown to Starship Flight 11 is gathering pace. Hardware is being assembled at a breakneck pace. With this progress, more information about the mission's timeline and objectives is beginning to emerge. However, what everyone has been waiting for is the official announcement from SpaceX. Now, those long-awaited updates are starting to arrive. The top priority is S-39. Its key components need to be moved to the assembly bay immediately to begin the stacking process. Completing the stacking process as quickly as possible will ensure the vehicle is ready for testing as soon as the necessary infrastructure is in place. At the same time, SpaceX cannot afford to cut corners. A careful balance between speed and caution must be maintained, especially as this marks the launch of the first V3 spacecraft. Ideally, operations and assembly should begin within the first half of this month. Once spacecraft integration is complete, a carefully coordinated series of tests, evaluations, and final setup will be required. Super Heavy must adhere to a similarly accelerated schedule. With the booster already assembled, the initial testing phase should proceed without further delay. The goal is to complete key testing within the first half of this month, especially given the recent installation of the booster's QD system at Massey. Once this target is achieved, attention will shift to readiness for the static firing test, along with additional inspections and system setup. Each phase must be executed quickly, yet with the necessary precision to avoid any hiccups that could disrupt the overall schedule. Another vital aspect is engine manufacturing. The immediate task is clear. SpaceX needs a sufficient supply of Raptor 3 engines for the maiden flight. This goal is achievable, but the larger ambition is much broader. To sustain the Starship initiative, the company must significantly increase its production pace. With the more efficient and powerful Raptor 3 design, Musk's goal of producing multiple engines daily appears achievable. This capacity is crucial because each Starship launch requires 39 engines, and the anticipated launch frequency at Starbase and Cape Canaveral will increase that need. In the long term, a consistent, high-volume production system will be crucial to enable sustained operations to the Moon and eventually Mars. Furthermore, ground systems must be fully accelerated. Production at Star Factory is already impressive, but gigabay completion is needed immediately to facilitate the next phase of Starship assembly. The testing framework also demands immediate focus. Following the S-36 incident, infrastructure was damaged and the ship's test site in particular requires rapid recovery. Ideally, all these systems should be operational within the next month or two, which remains a realistic target. After that, further development of the test complex will likely be required. At the same time, Pad 2 at Starbase must continue to progress in its testing phase to be fully operational. Completing Pad 2 this month or early next month will be critical to supporting the launch of Starship V3. In short, SpaceX's journey to a V3 launch this year hinges on accelerating all aspects of production, testing, and launch, while maintaining the reliability that is key to long-term success. SpaceX is now entering a stressful end-of-year period that could be transformative for the entire Starship project. This period marks the beginning of the highly anticipated V3 era, which introduces extensive improvements and advancements across all system components. Everyone watching understands the importance of V3, as its maiden flight will influence the direction of all future milestones. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one.